So I'm not going to lie. What's going on, everybody? My name is Chris, and welcome back to the channel. As you guys see by the title, today I'm going to be discussing three ways on how you can survive the Demogorgon from Stranger Things. Yesterday, you guys really enjoyed my Stranger Things video, so if you guys want to see more videos like this, comment down below what character or show you guys want me to do. Drop a like on the video. It helps push the algorithm. And with all that being said, guys, let's jump right into it. Number one, trap the Demogorgon in our world. It's a lot easier said than done, I know. But the Demogorgon is an interdimensional being so that it travels from our world to the upside down and back. When it goes to the upside down, it's usually regenerating, or it drags its food in there to eat it safely, usually because it figures that there's no humans in there. Nothing in the upside down is going to hurt the Demogorgon, so it seems safe. You're going to have to cut that out. The Demogorgon is not going to be able to go back to the upside down because you're going to want to hurt it enough to where it can't regenerate, and then you're going to kill it. I know it's a lot, trust me. So what you're going to want to do is trap the Demogorgon somewhere where it can't escape. Somewhere like a titanium metal room or a bunker. And before you say it's not doable, trust me, it's definitely doable. If you've watched up to season 4, you know that it's possible to trap a Demogorgon somewhere. Taking away its ability to hunt and go back to the upside down will definitely make it easier to kill, being so that it's going to be a lot weaker without food and without it feeling free. Number 2, light the Demogorgon on fire. Close quarters combat is only going to get you so far. Steve was able to hurt a Demogorgon for a while with a baseball bat, but think about it. What are your odds? You're going to want to try and do what they did the last time and trap it with a bear trap, being so that it's unable to go somewhere, and then light it on fire. If you have the option of having a flamethrower as well, that might also work, but I'm pretty sure most of us aren't going to have a flamethrower if we're being attacked by a Demogorgon. They seem to do horrible with anything having to do with fire, so it's really going to be one of your only ways to kill it. Escaping it may be easier, but killing it will get rid of it forever. Well, at least until another one comes. Number 3. Confuse the Demogorgon. Set up mirrors and mannequins around a house or somewhere where you think it may strike next, being so that the Demogorgon seems to only attack when it thinks that it has a drop on you. Every kill that I got in season 1 was on somebody that had no idea what was going on. There was a small light flicker and then bam, they were dead. There was no opportunity for them to act. Then later on in season 1, where everybody knew the Demogorgon was coming, Steve was able to beat the shit out of it with a baseball bat. They were able to get it into a bear trap, lighting it on fire, killing the thing. It's pretty much like a lion. It only attacks when it thinks that it has the drop on the prey. You don't ever see a lion going head to head with an elephant because it's just, the elephant's gonna stomp it out. It's the same way the Demogorgon thinks. It's only gonna attack when it thinks that it has the drop on you. So as long as it never does, you'll always win. But that is actually going to do it for me today, guys. Hopefully you did go enjoy today's video. If you did, please don't forget to smack a like on it. That'd be greatly appreciated. This was my three ways on how to survive the Demogorgon from Stranger Things. I'm going to be dropping more three ways to survive because this is a huge series for me over on TikTok, and I want to bring it over here to the channel because I think it's cool and I think a lot of people will enjoy it. So don't forget to comment down below exactly what you guys want to see me tell you how to survive next. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, smack a like on it. And with all that being said, guys, my name is Chris, and I will catch you guys on the next one.